Okay, I think primarily for men, I think one of the biggest things that men really dislike about ladies is the fact that most ladies are quite demanding, mostly when it comes to the things that pertains to finances. We feel that they are not realistic. So, and I think that problem is really, really very well portrayed by the latest trend. You're feeling even most of the ladies are preferring, other than normal guys, they're preferring to be sponsored. They're preferring sponsors. Because they feel that most of the normal guys cannot be able to meet their demand, because they're demanding. They're living a life that is not realistic. They're not realistic to what they earn and what their guys earn. So the demands they put on us becomes enormous, it becomes stressful, and I think basically it ends up breaking many relationships that could have gone far, because men feel pressure, you know, men feel there is quite a huge demand when it comes to issues of finances. So I think most men at one point they have felt like, I dislike this relationship, I dislike this lady, she's too demanding.
Okay, let me challenge you.
Yes.
You know, you said you want to impress a lady, so utaenda extend up uboro at a staff undo impress.
Yes.
You see, when you get into a relationship and start borrowing stuff and wanting to impress that person, that lady, that's when and I get impression you can do it, you know. Yeah, this man can provide me, you know. But wakati unaingia kwa relationship with your real you now, umuonyesha mimi kama unipendi vile niko, mimi siwezi provide stuff kama hii ama siwezi provide nini, unaona, mtaendelea kwa. But ukikuja tu into a relationship and then you start impressing her, ata get impression ya you can do it, you can provide me with anything.
Yeah, and I think it's the same na when a lady has makeup all over and then maybe you spend a night somewhere or you go swimming and then all the makeup comes down, okay? Like it pulls off and then now she doesn't have any makeup. So she becomes another person. And to you, because you're not used to this other person without makeup, it becomes hard for you to cope. Maybe she doesn't look good, maybe she has scars, you know. So I think it's better if, because most of the guys I know, they like ladies who do not have those makeups, as in natural. So I think for me, I would want a guy who is real. If you don't have a car, well, I don't mind. If you don't have a house, it's okay. Just tell
exactly,
me, don't.
Yeah. Just come clean.
Yes.
And I don't think, you know, you understand that maybe you're not the first lady coming to someone's life. Mm-hmm. So this person had another person. So and so there is that assumption, like, okay, these ladies are this way.
Yeah.
At one point they want this, they want a guy with a car, they want a guy living in a good suburb, they would want a guy who is earning good money. Yeah. So you see now, so it's something you carry with yourself. Even before you settle in a relationship, you know, maybe she will become demanding. Maybe she would want a guy who looks like this, somebody that maybe that she can introduce to her other girlfriends, and you know, not just any other guy who has, you know, nothing but maybe a dream and all that. And you know, we have gotten to that place where many things have gotten to a materialistic level, where what someone have matters, what somebody have, not the potential they carry, not the ideas they have, not how they are willing to implement them. So I think it's something that is in the subconsciousness of men, that many ladies want to be impressed. That's why you find, and I would want ladies to be frank, most of the calls you get of treats is on end month, not somewhere between the month. Mostly guys will call you around end month when somebody has some money to give you a treat. They cannot just want you to come when normal life, they go take you to a normal cafe, all that. They want to give you a treat that maybe feel like you will get impressed. So all that they are trying is they are working very hard to try to impress. And in the middle of it, you know, you feel the pressure of it. Because maybe I took you out, spent half of my salary. Now, the rest of this month, it will be very hard. Because I took you out one day, spent half of my salary, now I have to struggle. I have to borrow fair, I have to struggle, I have to see how. Now, until the next month, I have salary, and then I'll call you back, come spend half of my salary. So the cycle continues. So at one point, you feel like, okay, I can't take this long. And that's why you find it's very difficult to be with one guy for a long time. You know, keeping one woman for a long time, it becomes very difficult. Because it's unrealistic. You know, because this is unreal. We are all acting up. You're acting up. I'm acting up, everybody's acting up, nobody is really in this thing. Because everybody have that kind in their mind, they're thinking, if I'm the guy, I'm thinking like this lady would want, you know, I value you, I look at you and think, this girl looks expensive. I can't just take her into the normal kiosk and buy her madondo and ugali. She wouldn't eat at that place. So I want to take you to a place that maybe I feel matches the way I have. Maybe I have conditioned myself, maybe the way I've looked at you and maybe made up something. So I think many relationships end up falling apart because the demand is too much. The demand is too much. Because I have to take you out, maybe I have to make your hair, I have to do this, I have to do... And all these things are costing too much, maybe more than I can even earn. So,
but it's not good because maybe by the look of someone and then you say maybe this person would like to go to somewhere like Sankara, but maybe if you take her somewhere in a kiosk, she will enjoy. So it's not a matter of like the physical look, whatever. Maybe you can ask. I don't think most ladies.
but let me ask you, it's a common question and we'd want to put it out there. How many ladies will really date a broke guy? You know she's broke, you know he's broke, you know he doesn't have money, you know he doesn't have cash. How many ladies will be dating that kind of man? You know, he can't treat you. Maybe what he can afford is you go to his cubicle or his a bed sitter, you take ugali and skuma, you know, that is literally, and then you walk around the bush, around, you know, how many ladies would maybe date a broke guy?
Okay, so
let's be basic.
There are, but they not many.
Yeah. Yeah, no, you see now, the big percentage are those people who will have to first look at your pocket.
Yes.
So, and you want to give that lady, yes, I have a deep pocket. You want to give that impression. Me, I have, because you know,
that's where the problem starts.
Yes.
That's where the problem starts. Yeah. And that's why you find relationship, marriages are breaking, because obviously it's unreal, because not many guys, not many ladies will date a broke guy. So what do I need to do to give you the impression that me, I have money, I can spend money, I have money, I can have money to spend and to waste. So we can do this, but you know, that one date costed me half of my salary. So I have to struggle through the month. Next time call you for a date near the end of the month, you come, take half of my salary. So that's it. Because most ladies will not take a real man.
You know what?
When I come and tell you, mimi napata mshahara ya 12K, 15K. Eh? Mimi napata mshahara ya 5K. Many ladies will run away. They will not date you.
You know because why? Because you started at a high level. And now
no, I'm starting on a low level. I'm coming and telling you, yeah, me, I like you. I do this. I'm this kind of a guy.
Yeah,
for now, I don't even have a job.
But not
for now, I cannot
exactly.
Even
exactly. Not all men can pay that. Just a few.
So that's what I'm saying. If they do, will the ladies take it? That's the question.
Because most men want to impress ladies. They want to start at that high level because they think that. I don't know. Maybe.
No, it's experience that has taught you most ladies can take just a man who is broke. So you want to give that impression.
But I'm not broke. At times I think they just get ahead of themselves.
Yes.
It's possible. Yes. That is possible.
Yeah.
But because of that consciousness that not many ladies would want a broke guy. So you have to give an, even if you are broke, you have to give an impression that me, I have something. I can offer you something.
So, and that won't last long.
Yeah, it won't.
It will eventually die.
Exactly. And that's why
your true you will come.
Yeah,
out.
And that's when it dies, the whole relationship and the marriage just breaks. Because you started at the higher
level. And we are used. And we are used. Let's be real. We are used. You break today, tomorrow I go get another lady, create the same impression. You go get another guy, create the same impression he created with the other lady who was before you. And the whole wheel continues. Because basically, not many people can buy the truth. Not many people can buy the truth. If a guy comes and tells a woman, for now I don't have work, but I think I can give you love. I think I can give you, I'm a guy, I'm a sharp guy, I'm this. So most ladies will just not give him even a chance. So what do I have? Because I need a lady in my life, what do? I create it. I give you an impression, I'm that kind of a guy you really want, and I'm not that kind of a guy.
But it will die eventually.
And I know that.
It will be 0-1.
I know that, so I will go next time, take another person, and start the same thing.
Exactly. And yeah. You know what? In our defense, the reason why we act like that, it's because of how you guys come up to us, you know? You with the impression that you can do this. And you don't show us that you
even I think maybe this is off topic. If a guy comes and tells you I'm poor in bed, will you take them in?
No.
Obviously. So you have to give you the impression I'm good in bed. Not just money. I'm good in bed. I'm good in this. I'm a sharp guy. He will fake. I'm a degree holder. Even if he doesn't even have a certificate, he will tell you I'm a graduate. I have seen so many people I know, their Facebook profiles says they graduated from this university, they graduate, and I know they have never seen the you know, the gate, not even the door, the gate of a university. But because I know many girls come on that profile, they read and they think this is somebody who has prospectus.
This
is somebody who has prospectus. So you see, now you know it will not last. But you see, if somebody comes and tell you I am a dadahead, I am bad in bed, I don't have money, you know, I come from a bad background.
My
father is a drunkard, my mother is confused, my brothers are bad, I come from a horrible family. But that's the reality.
No one can describe him or herself in a negative way.
Yeah.
No one.
But those are reality.
We're not saying you should do that.
I'm a drug addict, you know. I'll beat you up sometime, I'll mess you around. You know, we're not. So you will come like an angel. So they will discover the devil later. You come as an angel, they will discover the devil later. Because you see, you know, if you come and somebody and tell me, the other girlfriend left me because I was so poor in bed. So you will leave the past. You not even, you know, the other girlfriend came because I could not be able to make her hair and all that. You know, my mother came and found out about this because she's very hot tempered. She hit her. So you run for your life. You not even give me the chance.
But you cannot say such things to our friend.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe.
But it's realistic. It's real.
You
want to build this from this relationship or this marriage, whatsoever it is, on the basis of reality. Yeah?
But not,
this is a reality. I'm a Form 4 dropout, or if there's something like that, I've never gone to college. I currently don't have a job. I'm not very good in bed. If you're looking for that, you know. So
no.
if these, those are realities.
Yeah.
So I'm telling them to you. So you get prepared. So when we get there.
You don't have to tell us.
Yeah.
You don't have to tell
but
us.
Listen.
So what do you have to do?
Let her find out for herself.
No, if she find it. If she find it on herself, she think I kept the information from her.
No, maybe you can explain. But we cannot meet on the first time.
Yeah.
Me, I'm this bad, this bad, my mom this bad, still was this bad. You cannot
you
tell
can't.
Me all
yeah,
those
yeah.
bad things in
yeah.
the first time.
Oh, how do I dispense these weaknesses?
Then
you will say I kept the information.
No.
Why didn't you tell me you're not good in bed? Why didn't you tell me I'm broke? When did you tell me your family is this bad? You know, why didn't you tell me you are starting
to
drop out?
Maybe you can be able to explain, but you cannot meet and then you start telling me that you're bad in this, your mom is bad, your father, everyone is bad around
you. So at what point should I tell
maybe
you?
Maybe later.
If you see that
relationship is really going to work, now you can start exposing yourself. You can start telling the person, maybe I'm not good at this, I did this once, maybe, but not every wrong thing you did at once.
And you know, at times you don't even have to say anything.
Yes.
They just come and they don't.
Yes.
They just come.
Yes.
Okay. For now, we have to wind up at that point. Maybe we'll continue with
this.
Thank you. They can never win.